The Battle of the Monkey and the Crab, A Japanese Folktale. In a lush coastal village in Japan, a clever monkey named Connie Uzajai and a cunning crab named Sarakani lived near a sparkling river. Though they lived harmoniously, they couldn't resist playing tricks on each other. One day, Connie Uzajai spotted some delicious persimmons hanging from a tree. The mischievous monkey snatched them, intending to savor the sweet fruit all by himself. Sarakani, witnessing the theft, devised a plan for revenge. The crafty crab approached Connie Uzajai and accused him of stealing the persimmons. Connie Uzajai, caught off guard, vehemently denied the claim. Determined to prove his innocence, he proposed a contest and epic battle to determine the truth. The following day, the animals gathered at the riverbank to witness the battle. Connie Uzajai climbed a tree, ready to fling persimmons at Sarakani, while the crab scuttled down to the water, armed with a sharp knife. As the battle commenced, Connie Uzajai threw the persimmons, hoping to strike the crab. But Sarakani, quick and agile, dodged the projectiles with ease. In retaliation, the crab brandished its knife, slashing at the monkey's limbs whenever it came close to the water. Despite their efforts, neither creature gained the upper hand. Realizing the stalemate, the animals called for a truce and consulted a wise judge, a wise old fox named Kitsune. Kitsune listened to their grievances and cleverly devised a solution. He proposed to test a game of wits. Each contestant would present a gift to the other, and the judge would decide the winner based on the value of the gifts. Sarakani, being an aquatic creature, offered a plump fish as a gift to Connie Uzajai. The monkey, in response, presented a jar filled with air, claiming it contained the breath of the gods. Kitsune, seeing the monkey's ingenuity, declared Connie Uzajai the winner. He explained that the breath of the gods represented the vital essence of life, far surpassing the value of a mere fish. The battle ended, and Connie Uzajai and Sarakani, no longer enemies, realized the futility of their rivalry. They decided to bury the hatchet and live in harmony, using their cleverness for more productive endeavors.